My 8-year-old patient had a notoriously troublesome brain tumour that occurs in children. We have a role as health professionals to constantly try and push the envelope of what we can offer our patients. So the Tyree IHealthE team made a patient-based anatomical 3D model. Using that model, I walk through the case probably 50 times before I walk into their operating room.
The main aim of the Tyree Foundation Institute of Health Engineering is to pair unmet clinical needs with novel medical technology solutions. So this kind of anatomical 3D printing is really helpful because at the moment surgeons essentially need to look at a series of 2D medical images and kind of reconstruct in their mind what the 3D version of that structure is going to look like, which is quite hard, as you can imagine.
So two of the projects that we've taken on have been the print of a trachea for Dr. Black and the print of a 3D skull for Dr. Banks.
The doctor, in this case, Dr. Catherine Banks and her team, gave me a number of files, CT scans and MRIs. I put them into a program and I paint it in 3D to define all of the different regions and I print it. This is the full brain and skull. I printed it so that this middle section can be removed. So if you see here, the tumor here is right in the middle. This is opaque brown. And then I modeled parts that would be relevant to the surgery. So for example, there's arteries in red. There's another one down here. And also the optic nerve in yellow. What Dr. Banks needed to do was to drill through this part of the bone in order to get to the tumor. After this project, there were several more doctors who wanted me to print some trachea models. So I printed the trachea first in this kind of transparent color, but I also printed it in several different stiffnesses to try to make a more realistic trachea where it would flex and bend.
So essentially I want to know what type and what size of tube would fit down the patient's stairway. So this child's got a few health issues, but the primary one that we're looking at trying to fix or at least arrest is his scoliosis, because the scoliosis has twisted and bent and compressed his airway so much he doesn't have a normal airway, and actually being able to pass an actual tube through the model gives you a degree of reassurance.
We sat down over a number of different consultations with our patient and his family and went through the traditional CT scan and MRI scan to show them exactly where the tumour was. And it really seemed to me like it was so difficult for them to comprehend. The real clincher was to sit down with the model. Once we had the model, you could see the penny drop and they did understand exactly what we're doing.
Beyond the possibilities of developing patient-based anatomical 3D printed models, these spaces are meant to be for, you know, tackling anything that is the prototyping of medical devices. We currently are in the UNSW Integrated Acute Service Building. We are indeed attached to the Prince of Wales Hospital. Making this space vital for co-designing, we'll have not only technical expertise and the knowledge that comes from UNSW, but the end users, which will be clinicians that come from the hospital.
I think the merging of health with people who are engineers and technical experts is absolutely vital when we move forward over the next decade.